fly fishing for tarpon is very, very unique. The greatest aspect about tarpon fishing, it's not really fishing, it's more hunting than fishing. And then you're trying to feed a 100-million-year-old animal that eats chicken feathers and jumps and puts holes in the ocean the size of your truck. So it's quite scary all in itself, and it's very compelling because of the hunting aspect, and you're hunting for big, big animals. And then to make it even harder, let's go do it in a tournament format. It's a pretty special thing, and especially when you go to this level.
If I had never fished in a competition, I would have no idea whether I knew how to fish. I do know how to fish, though. I found that out.
What I first love about tarpon is how old they are in the universe. There's nothing to me like seeing a string of tarpon coming at you, flashing in the sunlight, watch the sun gleaming off those scales, and the sleekness of the bodies and the brittle gill plates. I mean, they're just so magnificent. It's all of that, and you can't wait to do it again. It's one of the most exciting things that I know to do.
One right behind their boat, Paul.
I see it.
See him?
Yeah.
This is not an easy game. And because it is so visual, you get excited and your heart starts racing. And there are so many variables and so many things have to come together. I don't care who you are or what you do for a living or where you come from.
Keep it coming. Keep it coming.
It all boils down to you got to put the fly in an area of awareness that this big and talk the fish into biting it.
Are you kidding me? Got it.
Redemption!
Nice, Ed. Oh. Nice bow. Good job.
Fly fishing in Islamorada for tarpon is something that you do with a guide. Period.
And then wide. Strip, strip, strip. Hold on, don't move it. Now. Keep it coming. Keep it. You got him. You got him. You got him. Let him go. Let him go.
Oh!
He's coming right under the boat. No, 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 no!
I got it.
All right.
Woo! Friggin' win, man.
Hey, look. God dang it!
Are you kidding me?
God dang it!
Conditions where it only takes one or two weights keeps everybody in the game.
Northbounder, Paul. What are you doing?
What? I thought you just said what?
Oh my God,
I'm sorry. I thought you said turn me loose.
I said here comes a northbounder.
Okay, I misunderstood. What the f- think I would do that if I didn't think I was
dude,
supposed to?
No, dude, but I'm
to?
Just like, it's like f***ing amazing to me.
I know, but
you know, I say here comes a northbounder.
Yeah, well, I didn't understand. Just ask yourself this. I mean, you think I just walked up there and I was just like, I'll just let the boat off just for shits.
Rob is very good. Everything is very meticulous and very deliberate with him. It's like he's part man, part tarpon.
Take it. Go in the group. Okay. Just barely behind the lead. Take it. Coming. He's coming. Hit him. That's how you pick a fish and catch his ass.
Woo!
Bang, man. All right.
Not bad, eh?
All right, no, not bad at all. Not bad at all. Let's go do it again.
Woo! That's a big sucker.
He's going through. Come on, baby, don't. No! Ah!
Holy sh! He's big.
Oh no!
Watch the rod. Watch the rod.
Oh! I see it. It's right here.
Get the f- out of the way!
All that is just like, you got him! I love that.
We've got an hour and 26 minutes to catch four weights.
Oh, that's funny. We can do it. Is that a weight?
Nope. If we spend more than about 8 hours in a 16-foot boat together, someone's gonna get hurt. You never know.
Woo! Redemption, baby! Redemption! Pitbull!
Silver Kings is brought to you in part by Deep Eddy Vodka, Dive In Islamorada, Yeti Coolers, built for the wild, by SeaDek Marine Products. Your boat deserves SeaDek. Florida Keys Outfitters, your online source for saltwater fly equipment. And by Islamorada, the sport fishing capital of the world.